Like all new parents, my husband and I want what's best for our baby. We talked to our doctor about vaccines. We learned that immunizations are not only a good idea, they could save our daughter's life. Get the facts. Vaccines save lives.
I love my husband, but I didn't realize our difficulties had to do with his drinking. Our pastor suggested I go to Al-Anon family groups. I didn't think I would be comfortable, but I decided to try a meeting. The Al-Anon meeting really opened my eyes. Are you troubled by someone's drinking? You might be surprised at what you could learn in an Al-Anon family group meeting from people just like you. Call 1-888-4-Al-Anon.
I was mixed up where I was Because you got all them devils. Do I got anybody who got some devils on their job? But we come in here to get a refill. And we need to be happy about it. Y'all act like y'all just didn't feel like being in church today. Amen. I should be like my apostle. He said, well, y'all need to go home with me. Ain't that what he was saying, Darrell? He said, well, y'all don't want to be here. Y'all need to go home. Hallelujah. But I know y'all want to be here. Amen. Let's give God a big praise. And I think we can do better than we done did all morning long. We done prayed up something. We done praised up something. We done worshiped up something. And I hope something has been regenerated in you. Amen. You can be seated. Amen. I just hate coming to church where everybody seems like they just don't have no God in them. But the God I serve is a God that's a resurrected God. Anybody in here been resurrected from something? I have. I know everybody, you know, I've been resurrected from some stuff. Amen. But we're excited today for what God is going to do on our fourth Sunday of the month. It's always an honor to have my wife speak to you on the fourth Sunday, and we're excited about that. You know, I'm a teacher preacher, and she's a teacher. So she comes in to just tie everything together that we've been talking about this month. And what we've been dealing with is faith. We've been dealing with faith. We're going to take faith, favor, and fear out to the end of the year. Because, as I said before, where God is taking us is going to take faith. And I'm not talking about the next move. I'm talking about the final move. Will, I'm not talking about on Madison. I'm talking about the building we've been talking about and dreaming about and have already knocked down the walls and have already figured out where the sanctuary is going to be and where the daycare is going to be and where the recording studio is going to be. That's the faith I'm talking about. Because where we're moving is not going to take faith. All it's going to take us for us to go. That's already set. But for where God wants to really take us, it's going to take some faith. Tell your neighbor, you're going to need some faith. I heard a preacher say the other day faith wasn't until, he said when Peter asked Jesus, could he step out and come, the water was water until faith stepped in. Then when faith stepped in, it solidified the water and allowed him to walk on what was water at one time became a solid substance because of faith. But if you never stepped out, it would always stay water. Oh, y'all not catching this out of. And so if you want to get where God wants you to get, you got to first make a step. And if you never make a step, you can never get what God wants to give you. That's why many of us are still on the ship. When God can say, step off and watch how I can bless you. So we've been dealing on faith. We're excited about it. I want you to stand to your feet as a co-pastor, my lovely, pretty, just awesome wife. Y'all don't know how hard she works in the ministry. She is the business administrative person. She makes things happen. I mean, when I give her an idea, she runs with it, and it is done. She works up to 12, 1, and 2 o'clock in the morning while everybody else is asleep. The woman of God is still laboring to make sure that everything comes across. I thank God for her. I was looking back in my journal, and on 10-1-06 was the day I met her. And look at where God has brought us this week. Hallelujah. And I journaled my life, and that was probably one of the hardest years that I had, but it was one of my greatest years that I had, because every time I looked around, God was giving me a victory, and she was a part of the victory. So I thank God for her. Let's give the Lord a big hand praise. As I told you, I love you all. May you reach the time to give us the word.
Before I was diagnosed, I was
doing typical stuff.
Basketball, school for fun, football practice.
Mother of two young boys.
Took a blood test.
Kayla has leukemia.
Acute leukemia.
Myeloma.
Hodgkin's disease.
There's nothing worse in the world than this scare.
Who's going to take care of my kids?
I called the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society.
Cancer needs a community.
I know I'm not alone.
It's you who are the support.
It's giving people that hope.
With your help, I can be cured.
With your help, we can beat blood cancers.
Be there to give them hope.
To get or give help, go to lls.org.
Thank you.
how we need to act. Amen? So today, our topic is faith, fear, and favor. This is not the end, this is the beginning. Amen? This is not the end, this is the beginning. I want you all to turn to Hebrews 11. Hebrews 11. Could the ushers pass out my handouts, please?